If you want to understand how your application performance affects your ranking on Google, this is going to be the video for you. I'm going to walk through this amazing post from our CTO at Vercel, Malta, and one of our content engineers, Alice, that's going to demystify Core Web Vitals and SEO. So I'm actually going to just read through this post and add some commentary along the way. I'll also link this post down below if you want to learn more about this, but I was really, really excited to read this post when it came out because there was parts about Core Web Vitals that were, you know, maybe a little confusing for myself, and I wanted to understand kind of how it fits back into the bigger picture. So let's dive into this. Core Web Vitals influence how your application's pages rank on Google. So we're going to dive into what they are, how they're measured, and how your users and search ranking are impacted by them. So Malta used to work as a director of Google Search, great guy, and he has a lot of experience with this as well too. So a lot of this is, you know, public knowledge, but I think some of these pieces I didn't know until I read through here, especially the 28-day rolling window, and we'll come back to that. How Google ranks based on page speed. Your site's ranking in Google Search is impacted by Google's Page Experience Ranking System, which evaluates the performance of your site based on Google's Core Web Vitals metrics. Google collects Core Web Vitals metrics by observing how real users interact with your site and then reporting them back to its servers. We call this type of data field data because it gets collected from real users browsing your site. This is different from lab data, aka like Lighthouse, which is the result of tests being run in a lab setting to determine how well your site performs. Google Lighthouse is an example of this. So, big takeaway from this article, if you close the video right now, this is all you need. Google only considers the Core Web Vitals field data when ranking your site. It doesn't consider your Lighthouse scores, even though I know it's a great way to understand how you can make changes to your application or maybe take screenshots and put them on social media. It can be helpful for that as well too. But at the end of the day, field data is really all that Google is using. So helpful to denote the difference between those two. So let's contextualize some of these ranking factors. Page experience is a ranking factor in Google Search that utilizes Core Web Vitals to determine how your website performs relative to basically all other sites. Page experience is one of the many ranking factors in Google Search, which then all get kind of aggregated together to determine your site's ranking on the search result page. So of course, things like how relevant the query is and the quality of the content are going to be very important. They're very important factors of page experience. But for scenarios where you have kind of a one-to-one comparison with you and your competitors, when there's similar relevancy, page experience may decide who comes out on top, which means application performance can decide who comes out on top. So page experience and Core Web Vitals are unique. You can improve these metrics through your own work. You have control of your application code. And, you know, Google's pretty transparent about how well you're doing. They've been pretty transparent about how this process of Core Web Vitals works and how the changes to the algorithm and the metrics work. Core Web Vitals are much less of a black box than other ranking factors, and optimizing them involves far less guesswork. It's easier to measure than content quality. On top of that, improving Core Web Vitals improves the user experience, which ultimately drives conversion. I think this is such a good point, and we should probably, you know, make this one really big too. Just improving performance per performance sake is great, but there's plenty of data that also shows that when the site's faster, it's also going to help you make more revenue on your site as well too. So if you want to see Core Web Vitals, you have Google Search Console. Google Search Console is going to tell you all that you need to know about your Core Web Vitals, which is really nice. Definitely set that up if you haven't already. Another way is through Page Speed Insights. So nice tool where you can just dump in a URL and it's going to show you both the Core Web Vitals results at the top and then the Lighthouse response below. Okay, field data, Core Web Vitals. So at the top of the Page Speed Insights, it's going to say discover what your real users are experiencing. So Google collects all this global Core Web Vitals data for the 75th percentile of users who have accessed your application in the last 28 days from a Chrome browser. This was really interesting to me. I actually didn't realize that iOS Safari was just not being captured in here, which was kind of eye-opening to me. Google uses the first three metrics of this real-world data, largest contentful paint, LCP, first input delay, FID, and cumulative layout shift, CLS, to alter the rank of your application based on these scores. Now, here, you know, maybe by the time you've watched this video in March 2024, now interaction to next paint is also going to be something that's impacting the ranking, replacing first input delay. So these three Core Web Vitals are the only data that Google uses to affect the rank of your application based on its performance. And the scores are exactly the numbers that Google uses, although it's averaged into a group with similarly performing pages on your application. So there's tabs for mobile and desktop. That's because it gets ranked differently based on mobile or desktop users. So we can see here an example of, it's kind of meta, but of Google's PageSpeed Insights results for Google.com. And right up top, the first thing it does is it shows that the Core Web Vitals passed for Google.com. So these three metrics between beneath your Core Web Vitals can really offer you this insight into the user experience and ways that you can optimize it, but they do not rank the application in search. So it's just those first three. Which users are included in the Core Web Vitals field data? This is really interesting to me. So the Crux User Report, Chrome User Experience Report, this is the official data set of Core Web Vitals, and they, you know, they publicly document the collection methodology. So there's a couple bits here. First is that pages must be, you know, decently popular and publicly available. So that makes sense. So pages have to meet, you know, some kind of threshold to be determined in that Web Vitals report in Search Console. Users have to enable usage statistic reporting, sync their browser history, so just sign into Chrome, and not set a sync passphrase. So links there if you want to dig into more of those. And then they use Chrome or Android on desktop. The last bullet here means that none of your iPhone users are getting counted. This is just mind-blowing to me. This may be relevant insofar as that in some market, Android phones may skew slower than iPhones, so a larger percentage of slower visits to your site may be counted. So you can use that data with to help you add another layer of analysis to your Core Web Vitals data. If your app doesn't have enough real user data, well, then Core Web Vitals can't really be measured, and they won't be considered when ranking your application. Does it matter where my user traffic comes from? So something that we hear a lot, and what was kind of one of the genesis for writing this article, was, does the location matter? You know, do I get penalized if I have users in a lot of countries where they might have slower internet connections? It does matter where your users are coming from. Field data is trying to give you this real understanding that reflects all of your real users, and users from all global regions are counted equally, so it does matter. But the good news is that internet connectivity and device performance have been improving worldwide year over year. And if you use something like Vercel's Edge Network, you can get great performance all over the globe. Now, an interesting point here is this 28-day sliding window. So Google collects all of these vitals on this 28-day window, and your score is basically the average of the last 28 days. So you make an improvement or you make things worse, it's going to take a month for you to really understand whether that affected your search ranking, which, you know, could be problematic. You might want to react faster in real time. So we're going to show, and I'm going to pull it up in a second too, how Vercel's Speed Insights can help you get faster access to real-time Core Web Vitals data. Now let's quickly talk about Lighthouse before moving on any further. So lab data, we talked about field data with Core Web Vitals. We have lab data with Lighthouse. So the second section of PageSpeed Insights, it says how you can diagnose performance issues. So when Google does this lab test, it's going to simulate the performance of your application with Lighthouse. So this is the same thing that when you pull up DevTools and you click, you know, you want to analyze performance, exact same tool. It's a separate section because you need to really interpret these two things separately. First off, you want to make sure that you're satisfying the real users before you analyze, you know, every last bit of your lab data. Nothing in Lighthouse counts towards your site's search ranking. It just gives you some of that guidance. So it's definitely helpful. I know that it's helpful for me to catch accessibility issues or SEO issues or just other optimizations I can make. The Lighthouse performance score, you know, one of the most noticeable numbers at the top, is a weighted score of FCP, speed index, LCP, total blocking time, and CLS. So it combines a bunch of stuff. And after weighting, really only the actual Core Web Vitals represent basically 50% of this score. So first input delay and interaction to next paint aren't even accounted for here. So again, it's good, it's helpful, but we also have to remember that what's actually influencing your page ranking is Core Web Vitals. So the results are from a device emulating a Moto G Power with a throttled network connection. So it kind of just depends on what your actual user's devices are. Maybe they're closer to this, maybe they're not. It's still helpful to look into that. You know, there's some challenges with lab data, you know, not looking at a page that a user may be coming from before navigating to the reported page, make Lighthouse scores sometimes not suitable as the only UX metric, it's important to look at both field and lab data. For example, total blocking time as a metric often does not reflect the real user experience because frameworks like React interrupt execution if there is a user event, and they deliver really good first input delay and interaction to next paint. But the lab test doesn't know about this because it's only observing how much CPU is being used without real user interactions. So if you want to interpret your Lighthouse scores, they're still helpful, and here's some of the bits that you can dig into. With performance, it's going to help you find some potential issues, like if you're blocking the main thread for too long or specific elements causing LCP. It's going to help you fix accessibility issues, whether that's color contrast or links that don't have enough space, which is a common one, actually, like making sure you have enough space to tap on mobile. Super frustrating when that happens. Best practices, which is just kind of a collection of security and usability things, but worth looking at. And then SEO as well, too, just some of the technical bits of SEO. So helping search engines crawl your site, essentially. You know, they can be helpful when you're debugging, because you might not be the ranking you expect, but they're far from exhausting all of the factors that may affect your app's SEO. So that's not the only SEO thing you should look at. So now let's talk about speed insights. We talked about how that 28-day rolling window might not be fast enough for you, but Core Web Vitals is really helpful to look at to understand how your site is being ranked, and that's where speed insights is going to come in. So if you ship an improvement or a regression, you can take up to a month to see that data, and then you make a fix to that change. Again, it's going to take another month for Google to pick up that improvement. So if you really want to maximize your iteration velocity, that's why we have Speed Insights. Chromium browsers expose Core Web Vitals metrics to your site, and the Speed Insights package that gets installed on your site is able to access these reports with real-time data. So you can quickly react to problems and fix them the moment that they appear. So let's say, just like Vercel has these unlimited immutable deployments, you can view your speed insights on a per deployment or really even a per branch basis, allowing you to see the effect of each Git push on your application performance. So you can see the individual deployments in there, and I'll show you that in a second. Now, unlike Google's PageSpeed insights, you can filter data to smaller windows in the past 28 days. So you can see the immediate effects of your changes, you can filter by percentile, and you can see the results for different regions around the globe, so you can better allocate things based on where your actual users are at. So it's worth checking Speed Insights out. It's going to give you information without being tied to or associated with any individual visitor or IP address. So we've built it in a way that it can comply with regulatory limitations around the world as well too. If you want to learn more about this, I'm going to have this link in the bottom of the video where you can read this post and you can link out to learn more about all the different Core Web Vital metrics. So let's go take a look at Speed Insights, and then we'll come back for the takeaways. So in Speed Insights, I'm just looking at, my personal sites, Speed Insights. I have my real experience score, which is the kind of sum of all of these. And I have all of the different vitals here on the left that I can dig into. In this instance, I'm looking at the last 7 days, and I can filter by percentiles or environments or desktop or mobile. So I can see what routes specifically are doing good, and I could filter by those if I wanted to. I can see specific countries where maybe the time isn't as good based on the real field data that I'm getting from visitors in these countries. I can see ones where it was good, for example, or maybe ones where it's, really not good. And this just gives me this, overall snapshot on how things are doing on my website. So really, really helpful tool. Also, we'll mention that this is slightly different than web analytics, which is more of traffic analytics. So think like a Google Analytics, for example, where you can dig in and understand, visitor traffic, how many people went to my site, how many page views were there, where did they come from, where are the referrers. So separate but related thing. And I think this is also useful, not for Core Web Vitals data, but also useful for analytics. So takeaways of this video, of this blog post, hopefully we've demystified some of the Core Web Vitals SEO concerns or thoughts. Improving Core Web Vitals is the most transparent ranking factor in Google search, since you have direct access to the underlying data used by Google to rank your site. Only Core Web Vitals count for Google search ranking. Your Lighthouse score doesn't matter, even though it's interesting to look at too. Google's data uses a 28-day sliding window. So if you want to get those results immediately, you can check out Speed Insights to get you a real-time easily filterable access to those Corporate Vitals data. Hopefully this video was helpful to demystify parts about Corporate Vitals, the individual metrics, how Google tracks them, and also what we're doing with Speed Insights to give you real-time access to that data. If you want to see more content like this where, you know, we walk through deeper engineering dives that we've built and we show off some parts of the product like Speed Insights, let me know in the comments and happy to get back to you. Peace.